Alright, so what does this stuff do? What if I take that? Use it on whom? Oh, it makes me stoned. Any other effects? Not that I can tell. Well, I'm clicking it. No. Wait. There's a trick to this. Switch to the person who is not stoned. There we go. It's running away. These guys are partaking in the mushrooms. So we know what that does, at least partially. It would be cool if it healed us too. I mean, I don't know. Okay. What does the egg do? This cannot be used here. Wait. Cannot be used. Fragrant herb. I don't know what it does. I don't want to waste it. I mean, maybe we can just identify it later. And just see what these other things do. If I can. Glowing blooms. I'm the guinea pig for everything here. For all I know, it's increasing stats or something. I don't know. And then sparkling mushrooms. I don't know what that did. Okay, I'm gonna restore, and then maybe we can identify this stuff or play with it later. Did I talk to you? Yes, I did. The Council Hall of Dor Grestin. We'll go here last. Very strange place. This is before Morrowind, keep in mind. Way before. The person you are talking to introduces himself as a visitor from Dor Kiridan, and he says, "This town looks like a field of vegetables. Unbelievable. Hopefully I can soon finish my shopping and return to the safety of Dor Kiridan." Sorry, this place isn't safe. Oh, night falls. Dark time cometh. Ouch, I'm running into tables. Is that you, the same one that I talked to? Nope, someone else. The dwarf lady glances questioningly at the group and says, "I hope you had a safe journey. If anyone is injured, please remember that with Asrub, we have the best healer of the dwarf people. You will find him in his plant house in the northwest part of the town. Incidentally, he also has extraordinary knowledge of valuable herbs." Good, maybe he'll be able to tell us what all these things do. You're very helpful, thank you. The picture on the sign shows a few dwarfs chatting in a friendly circle. The text below it says, "The Nest." Okay. I don't like the name, but the fact that dwarves are chatting, friendly, and all this, makes me think it's actually an inn. Oh, it's an inn that we can walk around in. Huh? 48 gold pieces. No, not yet. Although maybe we should, actually. It's getting late. What time is it? I'm gonna wait a couple hours, a few hours. Or rest. I wish you a pleasant rest and wake up in the dawn, hopefully. Refresh by the sleep, you leave the comfortable place. Huh. So I wonder if this was an inn you could walk around in and it was like cut for time. What's this? I had a forward arrow, even though I was in the sleep mode. Oh, wait. It's still... Oh, wait, we didn't actually sleep. Never mind. Sleep until dawn. There we go. My bad. Egg. Nothing. Fragrant herb. The spell failed. Huh. Increase strength 01. Permanently? I want to identify the rest of these things. Is it gonna let us? We don't leave the comfortable place yet. Oh, we have to rest and then... The stinking mushroom. Ugh. Drug 01. That's funny. Oh, it's the bladder fruit we didn't identify. I mean, the other guy might just tell us what this stuff does anyway, but... Unknown. Again. Glowing blooms. Ugh. Increase speed 1. Bah. Now we have to rest again. All we're doing is sleeping here and identifying stuff. Last one. Sparkling mushrooms. Increase anti-magic. 1. Nice. So, I'm thinking these are more permanent things, which is great. I'm gonna rest again just to get his points back here. Gonna be getting dark again. Nice plant stuff. Are you that same one? Yeah, it's Darla again. So, I'm trying to map out the town. There's the north exit. I just want to walk over there. I'm not going to leave. I mean, I can, but temporarily. On the floor. Oh, there's more peoples over here. Are you that other one that talks to us and just says a little thing? Yeah, you're that one. That's interesting looking. So I was heading for that exit, but yeah, I didn't make it there. Well, that's a door. Is that an exit as well? Healer Asrub. A strong, fresh smell of plants and herbs surrounds you in the house of the healer. People feel better here after taking just a few deep breaths. People like us. We're gawking at all these plants here. Welcome! How can my healing powers assist you? They can't. I'm trying to talk to her. You speak to a young dwarf lady, hardly 60 years old. It's like a teenager or something, right? She answers, "Welcome, strange visitors. Do you know, I am very happy that Asrub is with us. I love the nature on our moon, but this is not the ideal place for someone with dreadful hay fever." She laughs and promptly begins to sneeze. Okay. The voluptuous dwarf lady turns to you and says, "Good old Asrub is a little strict. If you need help, please go to the counter and register." I guess that person doesn't exist. Oh, there. Take the appearance of a counter. An older dwarf with a thin face and dressed in a type of tunic stands before you. Oh, you're Asrub. Okay, that Asrub was at the counter, the healer. "Welcome to my house, adventurers from Lyramion. If you need my magic, please speak to my assistant first." Okay, maybe the assistant is the one at the counter. Assistant. Alright, let me ask about magic. "For me, magic cannot heal everything. I only use it in difficult cases or charge a lot of money for it, for I believe strongly in the natural healing power of the body. Also, a long rehabilitation teaches us to be more careful with life in the future. Often the use of magic is justified, however, as for example, on the patient in the bedroom, a poor chap from the mines of Dor Grestin." Oh. Who's the patient in the bedroom? "He is one of the survivors of the Tornak attack in the mine at Dor Grestin. His relatives brought him here. Not a minute too soon. I was just able to save him from death do speak to him. Tornaks. Can you tell us about Tornaks? No. Alright, let's go through the normal stuff here. Brog? Oh, wait. I always assume that I can say anything. Well, I hope to have time to visit my brother soon. Ugh. I missed it. Well, you guys can put back the video. Brog. I gotta watch back the video myself after I'm done recording this. Stop being so quick through things. Donner? So, Brog is his brother. We got that much. Dor Grestin? Dor Kiridan? Shrek? Hello. Oh, how rude of you. Journey. K. Ketnar. I'm getting more and more people to ask about. Kiri. Magic words. Mine. Problems. Snism. Storage cellar. Tempest fugit. Thing. Travels. And trouble. Okay. Farewell, travelers. What is this? This is apparently one of Asrub's medical instruments. Sharp but delicate, it is unsuitable for fighting enemies. Yet this here looks just like this weapon. Only not as colorful. What about the stuff on the table? I'm talking about that. You see a roll of clean cloth, evidently a bandage. Can I take that? No. Okay. It's like scissors. No. Okay. I'm getting descriptions for a lot more things than normal, so trying to be thorough about it. This is a drink which Asrub uses to treat his patients. Ah. Well, it's ours now. Oh. Healing potion 2. Nice. I could pick some of this stuff up. A bundle of dried herbs. Judging by the smell, they could be used as a disinfectant. Are you the girl that was standing by the counter? Or woman, whatever? I think she's a young dwarf, so girl might fit. Yeah. Bandage. This is a small bag containing a horrible smelling powder. I love all the descriptions of this stuff. This is a bowl for breaking down dried herbs. Huh, maybe we can make our own stuff here. That'd be cool. Really seems to point that way. Oh, there's the patient. A badly injured dwarf lies in his bed. He opens his eyes as you approach. Greetings, friend. Gorban. Gorban looks at the group in astonishment and quickly becomes wide awake. Welcome. How'd you get here, giant people? You tell him of your journey to the Green Moon. Gorban listens in fascination and then says, I certainly missed something, didn't I? Define something. Ask about Brog? No. A beast? Donner? Dor Grestin? Dor Kiridan? Dorina? Drek? Hello? Journey. Ketnar. Kire. Mage. Magic. Magic words. Mine. The mine at Dor Kiridan is only a test mine. We have not found much of value yet. With these words, Gorban stares intently at the fingernails of his one unbandaged hand. We sense he is holding something back. Oh, well. Should we ask again then? Well, as I said, apart from a few dozen Tornaks, the mine contains nothing exciting. Come on. I'm gonna ask him about Tornaks in a second. You are a patient? Do you have a problem or problems? Storage cellar. Tempest Fugit. Where's the Schnism? Trouble. Tornak. Okay. Those beasts, they were responsible for the worst day of my life. A few days before the attack, I felt that something was wrong in the mine. Things were disappearing. Lamps were smashed. We could not discover why. Then, one morning, when I wanted to go along a passageway, it happened. At one point, the rock was unusually soft and gluey. Yeah, I hate when that happens. Behind it was a whole horde of Tornaks waiting for me. I can only explain it by saying that they must somehow seal their passageways again. Yes, with the gluey stuff. Gorban closes his eyes as if remembering the events that then happened. Anyway, the beast jumped on me right away, and the others poured into the mine. It was horrible. When I have recovered fully, I will first take a holiday. I am not ready yet to go back to the mine. Let's ask about the mine again. Okay. Farewell. Hope you have better luck than I. It's curiosity. Welcome. To what do I owe the pleasure of your visit again? I do not want to join your party. So, Asrub, that's right, his name. I was trying to remember that. I want to ask about Asrub. I don't know what you're talking about. Is that his name? Hold on. Yeah, it's his name. Let's see if I ask him about the patient again. Now that I'm here. Yes, just speak to him. A little distraction will do him good. Okay. Well, we did that. What's this whole place? House of Asrub the Healer. Night hath fallen. Alright, I've mapped out this section here. I do want to check out... That's a big tree. I think that's the same one I talked to. That goes out, right? Uh-oh. Not you. I came out that way, I can't find my way back. I went out what entrance? Well, I must have gone out here, I guess? Probably right here. Okay. So that's the north exit. Trying to map out. We got the walls in here. Okay, heading further south. Sometimes those look like those little signs to me, and I want to read them. But they are not signs. No, no signs. Is this another exit? A sign here. Oh, back to the nest. Ugh. I didn't realize I was heading north. I'm not paying attention. Alright, so let's head south west. So that's that. And then around the corner. I've been there. Windows. Oops. We peek. Yeah, I didn't think that would work. I'm just mapping out the edges here. The barriers of our town, or their town. Pretty big place. I mean, it's pretty spread out. There's not a lot of stuff going on in here, but... as a town, it's a pretty decent size. Yes, let's head this way. Thing, a lone plant here. Oops. We still have to go to the council hall. I forget that. Kind of saving that for last. I'm sleeping right now, I'm sure, anyway. Oops. How dare you bar our path? Back by the exit we were at. What's your name? Oh, there's someone else. Sadness masks the pretty face of this dwarf lady. She reports breathlessly that her partner recently fell victim to the wild animals. She is not interested in talking anymore, and you withdraw. Oh, sorry about that. Now withdrawing. That's where we came in. Or that. That's the fountain that greeted us on the way in. That was nice. That bothers me. I must map it out. You don't understand. That's the door. Oh, so it's a separate door. Can't get in there? Okay. Okay. So only since we came here, we have doors that we are like apparently just for show. We can't do anything with them, and they show up on the map, which is strange. The foodstuffs. Alright, we'll go this way first. Okay. Don't get dizzy, guys. Don't get dizzy.